What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another match from the defense brought to you by JoinDota.com. And this is yours truly, B-Bond from DCCOM, bringing you another match from this prestigious tournament brought to you by JoinDota.com. You can, of course, get the match ticket replay from the Dota 2 homepage when you open up the game client. And it's definitely an interesting purchase. I mean, if you want to get full-on player perspective, if you want to get Toby live casting, if you want the ability to rewind anywhere you want and just get the player perspectives, definitely the Join Dota ticket might be the ticket for you. As it's really awesome that Valve is starting to put more and more tournaments. It's Gosu Monthly Madness has just been added to the store for only $2 because it is a shorter tournament. So Valve definitely keeping all the pricing options, and they've definitely done a nice job in terms of increasing the quality of their replays, because I know some of the complaints were that the audio was a little bit messed up. But still, this is a very exciting replay. This is still the group stages. Jesus. So many insane matches already in the groups. It started off slow, but right now we're getting to the middle of all of the action. mTw up on the Radiant side versus Next.KZ on the Dire side. As mTw and Next.KZ, the runner-up, Next.KZ, was in the International 2 West qualifiers, and mTw, of course, was the finalist and have qualified for the International 2 in Seattle, Washington on August 29th. So definitely Next.KZ going to be seeking a little bit of revenge in this match. And right now, we can just see teams going very, very aggressive picks by Next.KZ. And ever since Wisp has been released, they've been combining this Wisp-Ursa combination quite a bit. Not only have they picked it in this game, but I think they picked it in the Ghost League as well. And I think they won. I'll try to get my hands on that replay, but I'm not really too sure if I can get access to that. Hopefully, if the replay system is fixed very, very soon, we'll be able to get all the replays we ever want. We'll be swinging in replays. But anyway, just to talk a little bit more about Next.KZ, they've been sticking with the Next.KZ sponsor, so I think the Land Center re-sponsored them or something, because they have been sticking with this clan tag name for as long as I can remember, ever since the news that the sponsor quote-unquote dropped them. But Next.KZ, many felt like, rather than Mouse Sports, they should have been invited to the International 2 in Seattle, because they were the runner-ups in the West qualifier, and Mouse, of course, came in third for those qualifiers. But Next.KZ, although they haven't been as consistent as Mouse recently, and Mouse has definitely put on a show, performing very well at DreamHack, and just being a tremendous fan favorite with Sexy Bambo and Sing Sing, tagging along, bringing Mouse Sports to a top-notch team. Next.KZ has sort of stayed in the shadows, so, and keep in mind that this is all Valve's decisions, and if they felt like Mouse Sports might be able to bring more publicity and get more personalities to Next.KZ, it's ultimately up to Valve, because Next.KZ did not win the qualifiers. But surely they will be looking for some revenge up against mTw, who denied them their spot to get a chance at that $1 million, unless a second backup team is announced, which is definitely possible. I'm not really too sure at this moment. But introducing mTw, of course, recently they have been in a bit of a slide. They were number one for a while, now they're number four. But yeah, since the DreamHack win, they've sort of slipped off. They drew with M5, then they lost M5 for the Starladder LAN finals, or Starladder LAN qualifiers. And they also lost to Derer, so they were not qualified to get the Starladder LAN final invite. And just recently, if you watched my last game, spoiler alert, Na'Vi managed to beat them with a Wisp strategy, employing a global push all across the map. Just completely kiting around mTw. Not much more need to be said. Left mTw scrambling in the dust. It was marvel to watch Na'Vi play with Wisp. And so hopefully we'll see Next.KZ employ a similar strategy, but they are going with very different heroes. No Nature's Prophet, no Winner, not very mobile heroes, but definitely a lot more damage, a lot more late game on their side rather than the mTw side. So because we are in an AP remake, we do not have the band formation, but surely you can guess some of them bans. Looks like Nature's Prophet, maybe mTw, learned from their mistakes. They probably ban off Nature's Prophet. Winner not picked in the game, thank God. I'm tired of seeing that hero, guys. But Windrunner not here, Panda not here, Lycan not here, so we can guess some of the, at least four of the bans just from that information. Invoker not here either, so five of the bans right there. But just a couple of stale picks. Beastmaster, of course, seeing a lot of play recently, not only because he can stack these ancient camps and get a lot of farm with the wild axes that do mixed damage or physical damage to creeps, so they can hurt all the ancients. Venomancer seeing a bigger resurgence. CLG is definitely one of the teams that constantly employ Venomancer in their strategy. And mTw really likes Venomancer because of his turtling capabilities. The poison over hurts if you get Venomancer enough levels. Plague Ward's such a difficult skill to push against. Kabat playing the Vengeful Spirit. Sakshka playing the Lone Druid. Lone Druid is another favorite of mTw. So much that even when Lone Druid is not really first picked or first ban. People first ban against mTw just because they respect mTw's Lone Druid, and that's definitely one of the heroes that mTw went employed to great use on their scorching hot streak. As we see Fucking Mad playing the Enigma, so just judging by the mTw lineup, they have a mix of everything. They have a mix of team fight with the Venomancer and the Enigma. They have some strong initiation on the back of Vengeful Spear and the Beastmaster. They have good gank, and they have a solid late game. Pretty much a very, very utility-based lineup that can handle pretty much any situation that's thrown at them. They won't be very good at counteracting heavy push, but they can do that if they want to. They can push pretty well with the Beastmaster aura and the Enigma Eidolons with the Plague Wards, and of course Lone Druid, one of the biggest, baddest pushers in the game. And unfortunately, Lone Druid will have to face up against his fuzzy counterpart on the next KZ side, being played by Mantis Ursa, playing that Mantis playing that Ursa Warrior. And it's going to be really interesting to see how next KZ decides to utilize the Wisp Ursa strategy. Like I mentioned previously, they did use it in a Ghost League game, but I did not get a chance to watch that game. Maybe I'll check out the VOD to see how they play. They also picked up a Warlock and Juggernaut to go with the Crystal Maiden. So just right off the bat, you can see next KZ, they have a lot of damage. They have a lot of laning presence. I mean, Crystal Maiden, Juggernaut, one of the most deadly lanes in existence, just because it can dish out so much damage. So I expect Ursa Wisp to lane together, Crystal Maiden and Juggernaut to lane together, and Warlock to solo mid. And Warlock is really interesting here. We don't see him too much just because he's pretty ineffective in the early game, and it really doesn't happen until the mid to late series of the game where he starts to shine with his Fatal Bonds. And unfortunately, till then, because his ultimate has such a long cooldown, I think 150 or 160 seconds for such a sort of minor ultimate until you get some sort of item like an Aghanim's or a Refresh Orb. I mean, it only does 100 damage, and if you pick up a Diffusal Blade, that ultimate is countered right off the bat. So Warlock, a very, very difficult to use hero, but if you can make him work, he will work hard for you. Unfortunately, there aren't too many heroes that synergize well with the Warlock. They do not have the Venomancer on their side. They do not have massive teamfight. They have some Crystal Maiden AoE, they have the Juggernaut Blade Fury, but not too much that will synergize well with the Fatal Bonds. So I'm really interested to see how they'll utilize this Warlock pick. Meanwhile, Juggernaut, I think they're going to go for a lot of healing, because Wisp, when he tethers people, Healing Ward will be able to transfer the effects on Wisp and just get the double heal on whatever the Wisp is tethering, combined with the effects of the Healing Ward. So Wisp, definitely a very, very underutilized hero. And keep in mind, of course, I gave you all a little bit of Wisp history lesson in the last game. He was just introduced in the Captain's Mode scene this past week, and before that, the European scene did not even have a chance to play him in Captain's Mode. So enough of me jibber-jabbering. Equal playing that Juggernaut, Lucky playing the Crystal Maiden, Reese playing the Wisp, Creep playing the Warlock, and Mantis playing the Ursa, so let's get into the game. And this is a very, very strong level 1 Roshan lineup if they combine the Wisp with the Warlock, because Warlock can get the Shadow Ward up on the Wisp, heal him, and of course, the Wisp can transfer the healing effects onto the Ursa, providing with a lot of tank ability that would not have a level 1. And it looks like next KZ, they're rushing towards the Roshan pit, but surely mTw suspects something, because you know, Ursa Wisp, Ursa in general, when you're fighting against an Ursa, you always have to be wary of the level 1 Roshan. But it's not like Juggernaut is a very, very strong level 1 Roshan pusher. He in fact went for the Blade Fury rather than picking up the Healing Ward. And you can see that next KZ already migrating to Roshan pit, but mTw is onto something. They'll send the Baron to scout for a bit. And let's see if any positioning is coming in. Sashka is just staying the heck back because he wants to never die in this game. Looks like Ursa is taking a lot of damage, and so is Reeves. Reeves might be going down as a gale by Siren, managed to hit a couple heroes. Looks like Reeves takes a Magic Missile right to the face. Equal gonna go on the offensive work about. Can he get the last hit in the kill? Yes, he will, but meanwhile, he's in a lot of trouble. Next KZ, Mantis also taking a lot of damage. Will Equal be able to pop a salve? He's gonna pop the salve right now, and he's gonna escape for now. But meanwhile, it looks like Ursa does take the fall. Frost Nova hitting everybody, or Crystal Nova hitting everybody. And unfortunately, Syndrin will die as well. Syndrin does die, but now Creep is in a lot of trouble. He's going to take the fall as well. Insane engagement so early on. Will Lucky escape? He pops this out, but he's in a lot of trouble. Here comes the tether. Will Lucky just run away? They stun. They want to go on the offensive for Funzy. What are they doing? They already use a stun. Oh no, Lucky takes the fall as well. Unfortunate for next KZ. I guess they didn't realize that the tether stun had already been used, and he cannot dual stun with the same tether on the same target. So unfortunate play by the next KZ squad as Ursa, a little bit of a graphical bug right there, but it's all good. They are not going to go for the Roshan. The laning assignments are here, and all the element of surprise has been completely taken away. So we'll see how next KZ decides laning. Surely Juggernaut Crystal Maiden will be heading top, but it's going to be really dangerous to face against a Lone Druid playing by Sakshka up on the bottom lane. and he's already sending his bear just to scout the Roshan if Next.KZ is in fact utilizing that, just because he's left completely by himself, all to his lonesome self, and Lone Druid is truly alone at this point in the game. Meanwhile, Warlock versus Venomancer, Warlock should be able to handle himself quite handily against this lane. He has a lot of base damage, he has good attack animation, Shadow Ward will be able to neutralize some of the Venomancer poison damage, and if he casts Fatal Bombs, then Venomancer is going to take a lot of pure damage. And keep in mind, Venomancer, not nearly as tanky as Warlock in the earlier stages of the game. I mean, Warlock with those double gauntlets of strength, almost 700 HP this early on. Meanwhile, Funzi is going to try to scout out Lucky's pull, and he does so, but there's not really too much he can do up against this top lane. Enigma going to jungle it up, going to go for some 1v1 pushing if they require, or just probably most likely just to keep Saksha safe and get his relic as soon as possible. Meanwhile, Kebop runs in the middle of nowhere, gets done by this Tether. Will they be able to catch up the increased movement speed of Tether just doing so much where Kebop is getting blocked by the Wisp? Nice play by Reeve. And a couple more hits by Mantis will be able to pick up the kill on Kebop. Will he be able to escape? Magic Whistle gets casted once again, but here comes the Tether. I think the movement speed bonus will be enough as Wisp manages to pick up the kill. Sinner is driven back to save his ally, and Kebop is going to have to take his revenge another time. Looks like there might be an engagement over the haste rune. Fucking Madman to pick it up. Will he go on the offensive for Mantis? No, the bear, of course, is not in range to get any sort of attacks, but Sinner is going to come in. Does he fucking Mad have the Malefice? He does, but not enough mana. He's going to have to go back to base to get enough mana or get the Soul Ring shipped off to him. No, it looks like the Eidolons are doing a nice job getting the jungle up, and he'll be able to hit 170 mana pretty soon and going to get to jungle once more. He did have a clarity in the bank that I did not see. So nicely done by fucking Mad. They're protecting this bottom lane nicely. Meanwhile, looks like Next.KZ, they're content to jungle the Ancient. This gives them a decent amount of experience, a decent amount of gold, but still, you definitely get more experience and gold if you just lane. And right now, they're giving Sashka complete free farm. I'm not really sure if this is the best strategy. Of course, I think what they're aiming for is just to get their items, get their boots, and just get a lot of mobility early on, and get some sort of survival build, and then just go balls deep, all out. Wisp, Tether, and looks like they're going to go for the Roshan. Does Wisp have a salve? Yes, he does, so he'll be able to tether the Ursa and get some healing off as they're going to go on the offensive. Any wards being dropped? No, just a counter ward by mTw. Did not scout out this Roshan spot, so the Wisp and the Ursa should be able to rush in peace. The salve, of course, transferring to the Ursa nicely and going to give him some much-needed healing as the Fierce Swipes are slowly but surely starting to stack up, and Roshan's going to take the fall. But keep in mind, Sashka is completely fine with this. He's farming all game. And just judging by the lineups, Next.KZ, they do not have the team fight. They have stronger ganking just because Wisp is one of the best gankers in the game. I don't think they have stronger team fight though. And if Warlock has a miserable time, he's just not going to be too useful in the late stages of the game. He'll be pretty much food. He won't have many items. And Sinner already stacking up the wards, so Next.KZ creep cannot push any of the tower. Or get any sort of creep momentum his way so he can put pressure on the tower. As Ursa is forced to limp back off to heal up at the fountain. Meanwhile, his bear brother in arms is just happily farming away. Almost 1700 gold in the bank for Sashka, 14 minutes in the game. 27-15, last hitting like an absolute beast because he is one. I mean, look at this animal theme. We got Beastmaster, we got bears. All we need are lions and tigers, and we can just say, oh my, this game is gonna be insane. So we'll see how this shapes up. Juggernaut has not picked up healing ward, so it's not gonna be synergizing with that Wisp Tether to give the Wisp Tether ally more healing. He's picked up a point into the Blade Dance passive critical strike, and of course, maxing his Blade Fury as he should. You know, Crystal Maiden just pulling it up. Gonna get level 5 pretty soon, almost halfway towards level 5. So even though Next.KZ had a little bit of a difficult time in that early Roshan teamfight engagement, their lanes are giving them a lot of experience, and meanwhile, Kebop is just going to pull it out. Did die, so he's not going to have too much of a fun time. Won't be able to upgrade the courier, but it looks like the courier's already been upgraded, so it looks like he already did that nonetheless. So right now, the game has hit a little bit of a lull as Next.KZ is continuing to jungle it up. I think if they just place some wards in the jungle to protect the Enigma, they don't even have to block a camp. Just keep an eye out for the Enigma, because Vengeful Spirit and Lone Druid will not be able to get kills on this Wisp Ursa lane unless Lone Druid gets a multitude of entangled. But Next.KZ playing this very, very cautiously. I'd like to see them apply a little bit more pressure on Sakshka, who's picked up phase boots on his hero bear and boots on his normal bear already. So Next.KZ playing this very, very passively, which is not really what their lineup is designed to do. Let's see if they'll play more aggressive once they hit level 6 and get their ultimates going. Looks like there's a bit of a roam on the top lane. Fucking Mad popped the smoker to see as the ward is going to scout out through. And Fucking Mad has the Sol Ring, but he does not have Black Hole. Will they get a teamfight? Kebop, of course, is smoked up as well. Meanwhile, Wisp is not 06, so he cannot reinforce with the teleportation. As it's going to be an Omni Slash for Funzy, going to get the Frostbite, but unfortunately, Lucky did die to the tower. And now, Equal is going to die with the gank of Fucking Mad. As a phase boots, he did manage to cast the Blade Fury. Will they be able to chase? Kebop does not have boots of speed, and the phase boots is just too powerful. He's going to juke the other way, and Terror will not catch said of Equal. So one for one in that exchange. Only lasts a crystal main for Beastmaster. I think right now that is a trade that Next.KZ will be happy to take. But keep in mind, Juggernaut is using a lot of time, as it looks like Sashka is going to be ganked by his bear compatriot on the opposing side. Going to get Fury swept as Ursa had a haste rune. Going to get Tethered Stun as well. Kebop is going to teleport in. Will Mantis be able to escape? Does not have any sort of phase boots, but Kebop only can drop a stun, and that is it. So I guess that's what they were waiting for. They were just waiting for the Ursa to get a little bit more levels and item, and then just wait for the right opening. Picked up a haste rune and just went to town on that lone druid. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Warlock dropped his ultimate and got the kill before a certain man to finish off the Warlock in his stead. So Warlock picked some experience up, but keep in mind this ultimate has 160 second cooldown or 150 second cooldown, a ridiculously long cooldown for how much. It doesn't really do that much unless it does a lot in the early game. Scratch that, but once you pick up a Diffusal Blade, the Warlock ultimate is not really that strong. It has an AoE stun that goes through BKB, but it's not like it does too much damage. It doesn't stun for too long of a duration. But it's definitely a very strong ultimate in the early stages of the game, going to provide a little bit of pressure and force to kill some wards by Syndra. And right now, I think Warlock is farming quite a bit of gold just from these wards alone. We'll see if Lucky manages to get a gank off. Wisp should have relocate. Let's see the relocate icon being casted already. Ursa is going to jump into Nowhere. Frostbite up on Sashka. They're going to provide a lot of pressure on Sashka. Manage to get the kill. Kebop is in a lot of trouble. No mana for the magic missile. And Kebop is just going to get torn to shreds by this Ursa. But no, the tether was casted on the Ursa and then the relocate. What an unfortunate turn of events for the next KZ squad. Mantis is just like, WTF, mate. And that's pretty much all they said. Or I don't know. That was an Australian accent, but maybe we can get a Kazakhstani person to give us a Kazakhstani accent. Not really too sure how that would shape up. I'd imagine it'd be a little bit like Russian, because I think Russia did colonize a little bit of that area. But enough of world history / geography. Let's get back into this game. Sol Ring being picked up with the Observer Wards, and he's going to go for treads for the Enigma. No towers have been pushed, but they have killed Sashka twice. In the midst of all that, not picking up his farm. 50 to 25, so still averaging well over 5 CS a minute. So they're going to have to keep getting Sashka. He's just doing a nice job controlling the lane, denying creeps. Unfortunately, his bear is on cooldown. He has not skill tree form at level 6 or level 7. Of course, you're at level 7, you want to get that max level bear, but still, true form in the laning phase, it's pretty nice to get, especially if you're facing such an aggressive item. Aggressive lineup like Next.KZ is employing. I think I'd advocate for picking up that true form at level 6, but still, these players are much better than me. Sashka has definitely played bear very, very effectively recently, and I think bear is one of the key heroes of mTw squad. A little surprised that the Next.KZ squad did not ban it. I think they probably used bear to beat Next.KZ in their National 2 qualifiers, so Next.KZ should probably give the Lone Druid a bit more respect by mTw, but here comes their own bear. Gonna go on the offensive, Ursa and Wisp gonna just try to kill Syndra. Magic Missile and Mana Scale slowing a lot of damage. Next.KZ, Mantis also taking the poison over to the face. Mantis does die, but he does have the Aegis Immortal. Black Hole being casted on two heroes as Creep does die. Kebop fell as well. Lucky took a lot of damage, but meanwhile, Mantis responds with a vengeance. Can he pick up a couple kills as Blade Fury gonna be able to pick up one kill on Beastmaster? Ursa's on a killing spree, doing extremely effective job right now, and Syndra's gonna get slowed. Phase Boots and Tether just giving so much mobility to this squad. Will Syndra be able to escape the wrath of this fuzzy wuzzy bear? That is the question we're gonna see. Phase Boots gonna be continuous casted, and Gale is slowly but surely cooling down as Wisp managed to get the Tether Stun. They are not gonna go on the offensive because Wisp is so low HP, and looks like Next.KZ is just going to retreat out of there. Meanwhile, Lone Druid managed to pick up a kill on Juggernaut. Did not catch that. Haste Rune's going to be picked up as well as... No, looks like Kebop's going to pick it up just for some extra roaming. Kebop level 5, a lot of action in this game, but unfortunately they have not been able to keep down this Lone Druid. They've killed him twice, but he's still farming like a beast. Meanwhile, Beastmaster has picked up the Sol Ring as well. We can just stick out the early gold graph. Rain has a bit of a gold advantage, which is quite surprising considering that the Dire have a kill lead, and they picked up the Roshan, but that just indicates how well mTw is farming. And of course, it's not even a 1k gold lead, so this amount of gold is nothing at this stage in the game. But still, it's a little bit worrying, considering as the MTW squad gets more and more levels, they'll be able to get their goal advantage up higher and higher, so this is a little bit of a concerning trend. Will Next.KZ be able to reverse this? Looks like they're trying to get a lot of their kills just by ganking. But meanwhile, MTW is just going to push down the bomb tier 1 tower. True form has been picked up, so Bear is already ridiculously tanked. Will they go on the offensive for another tier 2 tower? They definitely can if Next.KZ does not reinforce, and trading a tier 1 for a tier 2, this tier 1 still at full HP, and they don't have extremely strong tower killers up on the dire squad. Wisp going to cast those spirits to try to ward away the opposing team. Looks like the Bear will get called back or resummoned. And meanwhile, Warlock drops his ultimate. Will there be a Fatal Bounce to follow it up? Frostbite going to be dropped on Sashka. Fatal Bounce dropping, doing so much damage. Vengeful Spirit is the first one to fall. Looks like Ursa managed to pick up a kill on Sashka as well. MTW's over-aggressiveness might cost them. They definitely do not have much experience against Wisp. And they might now be getting some flashbacks to that Navi match. Because Wisp with that goal of teleportation, so deadly in terms of ganking lineups, in terms of reinforcing tower pushes. But it looks like fucking Matt did a nice job killing the middle tower. And Beastmaster is going to be able to save this top tier 1 tower. So they did lose Sakshka, but they managed to get a tower gold advantage. And they did bring this tower down to very low HP. They'll have to, Next.KZ will have to die because it has such low HP. If there's any sort of push, then Next.KZ will lose that tower. And they'll be wishing to themselves, why didn't we just deny it, guys? And now we see the flaw in Next.KZ's lineup. Their ganking is incredible. But if they don't have Aegis, they have very much tank. And they do not have the best team fight in the world. Roshan will be respawning in about a minute. So it's going to be important to see how MTW responds to this. Will they place some offensive Roshan ward? Yes, they will. Spotting this area, nicely placed ward by Kebab. And of course, it won't be counter ward by this ward here that spots this hill, and this hill because it is placed right there, getting a lot of vision. Meanwhile, Equal is going to be farming it up. Going to go for a Battle Fury, but pretty squishy is Equal. Looks like Ursa is going to rush in with the help of Wisp. Can they get a kill up on the Venomancer? He has an early Ghost Scepter. Beautiful buy by Sinan so early on. But Blade Fury is going to be able to pick off Sinan. Will Equal die as well? Kebab is going to be able to get the Magic Missile off. If he has enough mana, will he get the swap off? Yes, he will. And mana is going to be coming in very, very shortly. But it looks like Equal might just motorway. He will be targeted by Tower, so Equal is surely totally boned. Will he go on the offensive? He will try to get some last hits up. And the tower is focusing creeps. Equal might be able to escape. No, he gets attacked by the tower. Unfortunate for Equal. He saw his opportunity to escape and he went for it. But unfortunately, the tower is just like, nah, bruh. You ain't getting by me. You will not pass. And meanwhile, this bomb tower is going to die to one hit by Sashka the Lone Druid. Sashka, 2900 gold in the bank. So he's going to pick up his relic very, very soon. So even though it's a 14-10 lead in favor of the Next.KZ squad, I think MTW, they're okay with this position. They picked up 3 towers that have not been denied. Meanwhile, Next.KZ has 0 towers. All they have going for them is more kills, a bit more experience, I'd imagine. Let's just check out the experience graph. Yes, Dire does have experience graph, which will tend to happen when you're ganking more. But just the gold graph, and considering MTW has a better team fight, which translates into a better late game. And they have Lone Druid, who I argue can out-carry Next.KZ's Ursa and Juggernaut combination. Just because Entangle and the tankiness of Lone Druid cannot be underestimated. Meanwhile, Ghost Scepter being picked up by Sinner is such a smart buy, and there's not really too much that Next.KZ can do against the Ghost Scepter. I mean, so much of the damage comes in from the Ursa and the Juggernaut combination. But Connor is not only the Ursa, but that Juggernaut Omni Slash. And only Warlock, he doesn't have the most spammable spells in the game with the pure damage that does not get amplified by Fatal Bond or the Ghost Scepter increased magical damage, because it is pure damage, which is a constant. It won't get amplified, so Warlock won't be as effective. Wisp, of course, only magical damage output comes in the form of spirits, which are not the most reliably hitting spells in existence, and they can be tanked by the teammate. And meanwhile, Crystal Maiden will just die in an instant if she manages to sneak her way to the front lines. So Ghost Scepter is going to be the name of the game as Wisp and Ursa are hunting people in the jungle. But there is a ward. Will they kill the stack? Reeve, he should break the tether, bro. Unless they want to go for a counter gank. He does break the tether before he relocates back. Nice play by Reeves as he's going to keep tethering up. But still, Juggernaut managed to pick up a tier 1 tower on his own. Pretty close to his Battle Fury. But no, he's going to go for Lothar. That Claymore is such a deceptive item with the combination of that Ring of Eld. This is pretty old school Dota tactic. Just hide your item as long as possible. And especially with the item like the Shadow Blade, which doesn't get countered unless you pick up Dust. The sooner you pick it up and the sooner you get that surprise initiation, the more damage it'll do, and the less time opponents will have to react with sentry wards and a dust of appearance. So, Shadow Blade, it's a very, very interesting item. I'm not really sure if it's the best item, just because it doesn't give Juggernaut survivability, just gives him a little bit more mobility. Well, next KZ decided to go with mass mobility strategy that now used to great effect. They don't have like Nature's Prophet or Windrunner or Boots of Trial, Sand King teleport in with a huge ultimate in, but they have a lot of physical damage. But let's see if mTw is starting to employ getting a lot of Ghost Scepter's Vengeful Spirit jack shit in terms of check out items really fast. Ghost Scepter being picked up by Funzy. Ghost Scepter being picked up by fucking Mad. Mass Ghost Scepter being picked up by mTw. Brilliant item choices. You know, Creep has done a nice job picking up Mechanism. Phase Boots being bought all around, giving next KZ so much mobility. You know, Sashka is very, very close to his relic if he does not have it already. Let's just check out his gold really fast. He will have the relic in about 100 gold. And once he gets that, and once he gets Radiance, next KZ are going to be a lot of trouble because they've only been able to take one tower. And once Glowdruid picks up his relic, buy it around the 20 to 22 minute mark, he'll be able to pretty much push down two towers for free. That's usually just happens. And Sashka might even be able to pick up the relic sooner than that, maybe around the 19 minute mark, if he continues getting uninterrupted free farm. And mTw, one thing that they're doing very well is they're constantly counter warding just to protect their junglers against Wisp. And meanwhile, next KZ, they're going to go for Roshan, but I think mTw might be just content to give it up. They have the Beastmaster give them vision, and they're just going to farm it up with the bear instead. Meanwhile, Eagle is going to jungle it up. 3 points into the healing ward, so he's going to skill the healing ward after getting 1 point into that blade dance just for a chance to get that huge burst of critical strike damage. But still, strong skill by Juggernaut. I'm just not sure if the next KZ lineup is strong enough. Warlock is not a strong ganking hero. Juggernaut, not the strongest ganking hero in the book since he gets countered by Ghost Scepter. I think if they want to go for more of a global gank, they want to maybe pick up a Windrunner, or I guess maybe mTw just ban the Windrunner right off the bat. So we're going to see next KZ go in for the Roshan. Healing Ward being dropped. Will Funzy get the Axes? The Axes does hit, but Mantis just tanking up passive lads. Gale's going to be dropped, and as well as Magic Missile and Lucky. Will Lucky die? Warlock ultimately going to be dropped. Will he drop the Fatal Bonds? Yes, Ursa picks up the Aegis Mortal, limits all that. Lucky will escape with his life as he runs the heck out of. You know, regen is going to be popped by Sinnerin as mTw is scrambling to get the heck out of there. Tether being casted on the Juggernaut, going to jump with the Omni Slash. Sinnerin drops his Ghost Scepter, but unfortunately the Omni Slash just skipped off to the other two heroes. Juggernaut picks up a double kill, and now Venomancer is in a lot of trouble. Tether, once it's up, will be casted on the Ursa. He's going to drop the Poison over just to drop some residual damage, but still, Mantis picks up another kill. Lucky managed to pick up a kill on the Venomancer rather than the Ursa, and now the Tier 1 tower on the bottom, it's going to be in a lot of trouble. So, despite what I said, this mid-game teamfight, this mid-game ganking and chasing lineup by next KZ is just proving to be really, really effective. And now mTw might have to be concerned. Next KZ, you're like, alright, we're picking up towers. Ursa still has the Aegis. We have pretty farmed heroes. Warlock has mechanisms so he can heal up. He has Urn. We have so much healing. And anytime you drop it on the Wisp and just get the healing up with his Tether creep, you get so much healing in that regard. So it's going to be pretty difficult to kill the teammates until Enigma picks up Blink Down and they can start synergizing their ultimates. Sinnerin going to go for Mechanism himself. Smart purchase. Going to negate a lot of the Fatal Bonds damage. But still, Fatal Bonds is such a long duration that I'm not really too sure how effective it'll be in just countering that one spell alone. You know, Bear is going to pick up a 20-minute Radiance. Ridiculous farm by Sashka, considering he's left alone in his lane for quite a while. And now we can check out the gold graph. It is surely swinging in favor of the Dire Squad. Not by too much. Very surprising, and I definitely gave the gold graph enough time to start swinging back. But still, it's pretty surprising how low the gold difference is. Dialin has like a 250 gold lead just because of that tower advantage and the fact that mTw is getting pretty much uninterrupted team farm. And if you gank one or two heroes and the rest of your heroes are farming, if you gank with three or four, then naturally you're going to get the gold advantage even if you do lose gold on death and the heroes pick up additional gold by getting a hero kill. If heroes like Enigma and the Lone Druid are farming, then ultimately your gold advantage will not be as secure as you would originally thought. And next KZ, they might realize this to their great detriment, and they are forced to back away. Venomancer and Axe is just doing so much damage to this tower. Bear is going to pick up his Radiant, so it's going to be pretty difficult to deal with. Will they focus all their attention on the bear, or will they focus their efforts on a hero like Enigma or the Beastmaster? And as more and more Ghost Scepters are being picked up, I'm I'm sure that Vengeful Spirit will pick up a Ghost Scepter once she picks up the money to MA. I'd advise MTW, okay guys, maybe you don't need the wards at this point in the game, just because you have such a heavy boost in terms of map control. We're not a ganking lineup, so we'll just save up money on our support and get Ghost Scepters for that. I won't be surprised to see Bear pick up a Ghost Scepter, to be brutally honest, as Reigns is going to just do so much damage to Lucky and the Warlock. Of course, Reigns not being as effective just because the Warlock and the Crystalman are pretty tanky, because they have been getting a lot of ganks and assist gold off. Crystalman's picked up a couple kills for herself as well. Shadowblade is now being revealed as Perseverance as well. I think Juggernaut probably picked up the Shadowblade in that last teamfight, I just did not notice it. The old Funzie buys 3 smoker seats in case they want to go for a gank. One of the great tools that MTW loves to utilize, if they are down, they just go for gank with all 5 of their heroes. Try to kill one, and then they use their Lone Druid just to tank up the next teamfight to great effect. But it looks like Next.KZ, they want to take this team fight. They have the Aegis up still on the Ursa Warrior. Has the Blink Dagger so he can go in for the initiation, but the Venomance wards are doing a nice job just constantly hitting the Blink Dagger targets. The Bear is going to die, 100 gold being given up, but the Bear will be resummoned just for a little bit of damage versus Sakshi. We picked up Boots of Tranquility, going to give some mobility, and I guess his plan is just to stay back for now and just let his Bear do all the work at this moment. But will he face up against this other Bear? That'll be the true question, as slowly but surely, positioning is starting to take shape. As I keep misclicking on the minimap. Fucking man, not close to the Blink Dagger, has picked up a headdress for himself. Will he go for a pipe? It will not do too much, in my honest opinion. May just want for some extra regen, for extra pushing. Swap gonna go in for the walk. If they can kill the walk, he did not drop his ultimate. Can they kill the walk? He will be able to drop his ultimate. He's pops the mechanism. Ursa picks up a kill on Kabop immediately. Black hole being dropped, catching 3 heroes. What a sensational black hole by fucking Matt. But Ursa and the Dire Squad are a little bit too tank at this point in the game. Equal picks up a kill on fucking Matt. And now Sundren pops Ghost Scepter, but he's gonna be a lot of trouble. Blade Fury doing a lot of magical damage. Next.KZ taking that team fight, only lost to Warlock, and the Ursa still has Aegis. The Aegis just now expires. And now Next.KZ gotta feel pretty good about themselves. They are feeling themselves after this last team fight. Just the mass mobility and the takeability of the Dire Squad was something to behold. Wisp giving a lot of healing. Warlock just too tanky. Managed to pop the Mechanism, Ultimate, and Fatal Bonds before he died. And yeah, I'm pretty surprised that Next.KZ won that teamfight in such a convincing fashion. The only thing that went right for MTW is that their Bear did not die. I thought for sure when that black hole was dropped, which caused at least 3 heroes, that was channeled for 2 or 3 seconds. I don't know what broke the stun. Maybe it was a tether or a frostbite. But still, I thought for sure when that swap happened and the black hole caught 3 heroes, I thought MTW was looking in tip-top shape. But unfortunately, they did not take the fight as convincingly as thought, and they lost the team fight instead. Blink Dagger being picked up by fucking Matt just managed to pick that up. So he's gonna drop the ward, or maybe he just had it and I just was too slow on the uptake to notice. But now Lucky's in a lot of trouble, gonna get slowed down. Axes, and the Bear is gonna clean it up. Funzie managed to pick up the last hit. So a little bit of overextension by the Next.KZ squad with their Crystal Main. Yeah, Ursa getting dangerously close to that BKB. But there are a lot of tools that can counteract the BKB. Not really too sure BKB is the smartest choice. I mean, what will BKB do for you as an Ursa Warrior in this game? In most games, it'll allow you to attack freely. But in this game, you're going to get Ghost Sceptered. You're going to be forced to change your targets constantly. You're going to get roared, blackholed, or swapped by some time. And just so many counters against this Ursa BKB that I'm not too sure if it's the best item. What would he go for instead? Maybe a Blade Mail just to outlast some of the damage. It's definitely a useful item in any sort of the game. So you can just draw off some of the focus, wait for the Ghost Scepters to cool down while you're not getting focused by any sort of spells. And now MTW is just going to push in. They're saying, okay, we're down and killed, but still, we have stronger pushing. And what are you going to do about it when we're all just grouped up as 5? Sindarin is level 11, so he has a very strong ultimate. Just pick that up right now. And has Mechanism as well. Meanwhile, Funzie has Smoker Deceit. Will they pop it? Looks like they just used it. Sakshka is just like, alright, going to finish up my Vlad. Going to keep farming. If you let me farm, I will do so happily. Vlad is finished on Sakshka. And now we'll check out the gold graph. After several kills went in favor of the Next.KZ squad, MTW immediately retaliated by killing the Crystal Man and picking up a tower. So this gold graph is one of the most even gold graphs I've seen in a long time. Only MTW got a little bit of lead with those tower kills. But now it's just been staying very, very close to that zero line. for the past 10 minutes. So how will Next.KZ respond to this, just this, you know, not stubbornness by mTw? And now mTw is saying, alright, well, we're just going to stay as 5-4 or 5, and what will Wisp do to gank us? Now Wisp will have to employ, is he pretty stacked? Will he get a lot of, he has Drums and Medallion on Arcane Wood, so he's pretty stacked as far as Wisps go. And now he's going to get that overcharge, he's going to give his Ursa a lot of attacks, so he's going to overpower is done, going to give his Ursa a lot of reduced damage. And keep in mind, Wisp with the tether just going to be able to survive a lot of fights. And right now, I did say before in my last cast, Wisp does not scale well when he doesn't have items, just because he's pretty easy to kill. And if you focus him, he will die. But this Wisp has enough farm that he will scale extremely well into the late game, if it goes that late. But still, will he be able to match up against a Black Hole and a Bear? Not really too sure. Mantis is going to fight out mano y mano versus the other Bear. It's just going to get Reese on Wolf Funds. You get the Roar up on Mantis, gets the Roar up on Reeves instead. Wisp going to take a lot of damage. Sinon drops a huge Venom Scale. The Ghost Scepter is popped. Looks like fucking Matt is going to be the first one to die to equal. And meanwhile, Fatal Bonds and the Warlock Ultimate just doing huge amounts of damage. Sinon is going to be the next one to die. As Wisp did die in the midst of all that towards the mTw squad. Kebab is going to try to get the swap off. Did Ursa lose the Roshan? HC did. He's going to try to do a lot of damage, but Londra did take the fall as well. Next.KZ just cleaning up the mTw squad as Kebab is going to be able to teleport out just fine. But still, they lost their Londra in that engagement. And is Next.KZ just too tank at this point in the game? They focused on the Wisp and the Ursa. So I don't know if Next.KZ can just go for a straight up push against Axe's Terror and the impending threat of a swap, which has a short cooldown. But still, they can apply a little bit of pressure nonetheless, with the help of that healing ward, constantly giving his team a lot of HP regeneration. That's what healing ward does. Obvious statement is obvious. Meanwhile, that golem dies as Warlock is going for Aghanims. I love it. I think Warlock with Aghanims is one of the most game-breaking ultimates in the game. And once he picks up that double golems with insane amount of burn damage through the help of that immolation that stacks fully, and the fact that, okay, you have a lot of Ghost Scepters, so that immolation damage will do a lot. Meanwhile, Wisp just relocates out after they farm the jungle for a little bit. He's not going to relocate back in. He's too smart for that. Meanwhile, mTw is trying to desperately regain some map control. Towers are all down for the Next.KZ squad, aside from the base tower. Meanwhile, two tier 2 towers are remaining on the side of mTw, checking out the item progression, since I haven't done that. Ghost Scepter is still up. Blink Dagger being picked up by the Enigma. He had that a couple fights ago. Beastmaster has not made too much iron progression. Mantis picked up that BKB. What will Equal go for? He goes for a Battle Fury. He had a Perseverance for a while. And meanwhile, looks like the Warlock pretty close to his Aghanim Scepter. Like I mentioned earlier, the Blade of Alacrity is in his stash, so it's going to be shipped on the way. Lucky has a Vitality Booster as well as a Staff of Wizardry, so he's getting pretty farmed. Might go for a Rod of Eidos to slow down his opposing team, as Reese is going to be a lot of trouble. He's going to take the fall, despite the Force Staff. Where would the Force Staff come from? I guess Equal. No, Lucky's gonna get ganked. The Smoke of Deceit just tearing Next.KZ to shred, and now the Roshanites respond. If mTw take this, this might be some of the momentum they need to start getting themselves back in game. Because although they have a Tower Gold lead, they are losing pretty much every single team fight. And if they take this Roshan, it'll be a huge step in countering some of that. As Mantis blinks in, gonna get a couple heroes, but it looks like he gets immediately tangled despite the BK. Mantis just taking Roshan like a beast. But unfortunately, he can't do too much. Juggernaut gets the Omni Slash, but now Londrid is just outlast. Ghost Scepter is just proving to be such a nuisance. Juggernaut is just going to get right-clicked down. Will he pop the Shadow Blade? He will pop the Shadow Blade. But guess what? There is a Sanctuary. I'm not really sure about that initiation, as everybody but the Wisp, actually every hero died on the Next.KZ squad. Free Roshan being picked up. And that Roshan might be the death knell for Next.KZ, but still way too early to call. If Next.KZ manage to take a 5v5 team fight and can stop the Black Hole, they should be able to win it pretty easily, just because they have very, very tanky heroes. But now I can see the powers of Ghost Scepter running heroes like Juggernaut and Ursa very, very effectively. And Bear just one of the best counter pushes in the game, counter chases in the game, just because Entangle is such a bitch to deal with. My god, is the ultimate cockblock. Meanwhile, fucking Mad, along with Becca Silver, gonna take that Roshan team fight. And will they go up? Will they be able to take this middle rack? So Warlock and Juggernaut still have a decent amount of time to respawn, and ultimates are down for the Juggernaut and the Warlock. So I think mTw will just take this middle rack for free. And this is pretty surprising, but that just, you cannot underestimate the pushing power of a lone druid. And he has a Hyperstone as well. His farm rate has slowed down considerably, but still, 30 minutes, Hyperstone, Radiance, Tranquil Boots, and Vlad's is still pretty ridiculous. Barret has almost 200 CS. Meanwhile, Funzi is just going to keep on the axes, and that was the third Roshan, so he does have to cheese to his name. And now Next.KZ had to play this very close to the bone. Play this very cautiously. Will they go for a Smoker to Seek Gank and try to pick off the bear and at least kill the Aegis before they can get the heck out of there? Or will they try to take a 5v5 team fight? It might be too late to take a 5v5 team fight, despite what I just said, just because the MTW squad got so much gold from killing this tower along with the bear. And Beastmaster picks up an immediate Necro 2. Yep, Necro 2 is going to give himself a light edge, as well as reveal the Juggernaut without having to use Sentry Wards all the time. And of course, those Necrobook illusions, or those Necrobook Warriors, will do a huge amount of damage in conjunction with that Inner Beast Aura. Now, what will Mantis do? You just saw how ineffective BKB was during that teamfight. They did not even have to throw down that many spells. I mean, it's good against Malphus, but just Bear Entangle goes right through BKB. It's just trolling up this Ursa mad hard. And I'm not really too sure if the item decision by Next.KZ's Ursa is going to give him, and the item decision by even the Juggernaut. But Warlock does have his ultimate stick. This might be the fight that they want. Even though they did have the double ultimate casted, it was not perfectly taken in that last team fight. So if they can get a perfect double ultimate off and disable the Black, as Lucky's going to just dive in, try to go balls deep for this Enigma, but Lucky's going to die immediately. You know, Mantis gets stunned as the double ultimate is casted. Mantis just chain stun, Black Hole catching three heroes at the very least, before fucking Matt dies, and Warlock is forced to retreat. Juggernaut taking too much damage as Wisp is tethering the Golem, but still, you cannot run, you cannot hide from Beastmaster and Avenged Spirit on your ass. And now, Wisp will die once more, casting everything he can just to give himself some sort of escape, but right now he's just wasting time, just waiting for his allies to respawn. But still, a convincing team fight taken by MTW, and now the momentum is clearly in MTW's favor. And that team fight was pretty good, but what you just saw, even with the BKB, Ursa just got trolled. He was held in place for so long, and every time he attacked somebody, the Ghost Scepter just completely nullified any sort of damage. So unfortunate for the Ursa, but MTW have completely countered him. And this is why you don't see Ursa in pro games aside from Next.KZ. Just because Ghost Scepters and all that, just too useful. Either BKB, maybe if Ursa went for an AC, give himself some armor, Blade Mail like I suggested earlier to give him some tank ability and give him some damage that goes through Ghost Scepters. Or even something going for a Vip Booster or a Reaver rather than a BKB might have been a smarter decision, in my honest opinion. And even with that Warlock double ultimate, which I still maintain is one of the most game-breaking ultimates in the game, once you pick up that, you should win a team fight. Unfortunately for the Next.KZ squad, they did not win a team fight, and now they are in a lot of trouble. Four staff is the item for Crystal Maiden. Meanwhile, Beastmaster will have the Necro 3 finish. Check out the items on MTW squad. Venomancer is still pretty poor, has a dust appearance along with Magic Wand. BKB being picked by the Enigma, so you could just wait out the Warlock ultimate and just cast his BKB and go in for a full duration Black Hole. Meanwhile, Equal is going to get hit by the bear. Will the Entangle get off? No. As we can look at the items, Yasha being picked up by the Juggernaut. Any items being picked up by the bear. AC should be very, very close to finishing. AC is finished by the Soul Bear. And that's going to give MTW so much advantage when they push in, when they decide to take it to the base. But MTW style, just play it slow, play it safe, wait for the other team to make a mistake. And unfortunately for Next.KZ, they are forced to be aggressive. Their lineup is completely revolving around the fact that they are an aggressive lineup that can get easy hero kills when they gank. But unfortunately, MTW just playing very, very safe. And without heroes like Furion or Windrunner who can just teleport around the map like Na'Vi utilize, they're not in too much worry. They can constantly stay as 3 or 4 or 5 and guard themselves against any sort of Wisp ganks. Now I'm really interested to see what the ban information was. Maybe I can get that to you, post that in the description if I manage to find the information before this happened. I'll probably look at the Join Dota VOD and just see what the ban information was, because I'm really interested to see what MTW decided to ban and what order the Wisp was picked up. I imagine Wisp was picked up with the first three picks by the Next.KZ squad, but now we see MTW going the offensive, fatal bond string drop, only on the bear, not even dropped on any of the heroes. So the bear is just gonna tank that fatal bond damage like a beast, because he could be resummoned at any time he wants. You know, sooner than 3,200 gold in the bank, Enigma, or Beastmaster, Necrobook level 3, the summons are, they're probably gonna wait for the Necrobook to get recasted. Gem being picked up by the Vengeance Spirit along with the Ghost Scepter. Four Ghost Scepters on the MTW squad, so all the slashes will go on the Silver. We can just tank it up. And meanwhile, Silver is gonna go on the offensive, blinking by fucking Matt, gonna get the Malefice, and next KZ Lucky will die towards the Entangle, but looks like Lundred managed to pick off Mantis once more, despite the Warlock ultimate. Mantis is forced to buy back, Creep is gonna get swapped and stunned. Will they go for Creep? He already dropped his ultimate, he's trying to channel his upheap. Mantis is gonna blink back, he can't do anything, he's continuously chain stunned. The Entangle is just doing so much work. Warlock picks up a double kill on the back of Fatal Bomb. And next KZ might just be able to hold, and Funzi is the only sole survivor up by the MTW squad as Enigma bought back. No, Sakshka had the Aegis, he turns in back into the Super Bear, and now he's gonna go kill everybody, kill your base, kill your mother, kill your father, and leave nobody left for you to survive. Funzi is gonna die, but he does have Ghost Scepter up in 8 seconds. Lundred picks up a double kill, gonna go for Mantis. Mantis died after Funzi took the fall, and now Wisp is in a lot of trouble. Unfortunately, the Necrobook Warriors are gonna have to be microed a bit better, but Wisp is gonna die. Bear is just too difficult to deal with at this point in the game. 30-28 in favor of MTW, but now the barracks are just too getting to become too much of an issue. I honestly do not see much of a way of next KZ unless MTW makes a huge slip up. But hey, we've seen bigger and crazier comebacks in Dota. But still, I do not imagine a team who plays as cautiously, as safe as MTW will make such a game-breaking mistake and allow next KZ to get themselves back in the game. Meanwhile, Ursa, you saw BKB got completely shut down. I feel like a broken record, but it's just not proving to be a very smart purchase. Invisibility rune is picked up, but Bear is just going to TP out. As Bear, I think, might have seen that. No, but still, he does have a Bear, so he can see anything he wants. Basher being ticked up by the cute bear, not the ugly bear, by the pet bear. So he's gonna go for probably an Abyssal Blade to go right through BKB, just adding insult to injury, just saying Ursa, BKB was like the worst item you could have gotten. And if Abyssal Blade is finished, that Ursa will just be completely heartbroken. Fuzzy Wuzzy will not be able to go on any sort of, not be able to give his huge man hugs towards any hero. But credit to next KZ, they played their strategy extremely well in their early stages of the game, but that one Roshan fight might have swung the favor in MTW's. I mean, they let Bear farm, but still, they were killing Bear pretty much every engagement. Just that Wisp dying and next KZ taking that team fight without the Wisp, and the fact that Ursa blinked into the Roshan, got bashed, got entangled, and just couldn't do anything might have been the death knell for the next KZ squad, as MTW is going to push in. Will they try to finish the game? Yes, they will. They sense blood, they sense weakness. They do not want to leave next KZ open to any sort of comeback, so might as well take the fight while they have the biggest advantage. Black Hole is not up, but it'll be up in 18 seconds, so that's when I expect the push to come in. Venomancer's ultimate is up. He has an Agnum Scepter, going to give his ultimate a huge amount of damage. So now Bear is just going to send his Bear in. Will they be able to kill the Bear before he kills the Rex? AC just doing a lot of damage. Medallion of Courage going to be able to melt the bear, but still, the bear managed to kill the Rex by himself as Mantis is forced to go on the offensive, but now he gets immediately tangled. First hit entangled, just completely owning Mantis. Roar being casted as well. Ultimate being dropped only on Sakshka, who can just like, okay guys, I'll tank it. Tether and Juggernaut going to be casted as well. Black Hole being casted on three heroes, or two heroes in Golems. My bad, the health bar is very, very deceptive. As Lone Druid managed to get a double kill. GG being called by next KZ. As a very, very well played game by MTW, despite being pressed very, very heavily in the early game. Remember, it was 11-20 in favor of next KZ, and they picked up both Roshans and were getting themselves back into the tower game. But that one Rosh fight spelled the death of the next KZ squad. A little bit disappointed not to see Ursa win, because y'all know my feelings about that bear. He's just too cuddly to hate. But still, the next KZ squad did fall, but hopefully that is not the last. Keep in mind that you can check the Join Dota site for the rankings in the groups, but I imagine MTW and Na'Vi at the top of their group. I'm not too sure if four of the teams advance out of the groups, how many groups there are, or three teams. Still, Na'Vi, MTW, and Next.KZ all in the same group, a very, very threatening group. And hopefully I'll be able to bring you some more defense matches very, very soon. So thank you all for watching as usual. And despite Lone Druid's farm, I remember reading some of the comments saying that they just let MTW's bear farm too much. I think Next.KZ had it until that Roche teamfight. And we've seen the last couple of games, not only in Dota 1, but in Dota 2, Roche fights just mean so much. And even though the Next.KZ squad is dire, you can see that Radiant have a lot of avenues to initiate from, and they can just counteract a lot of the wards, so they can go in and take a teamfight on multiple angles and flank out the Dire squad. So still, even though Dire has a natural Roche advantage, so many angles can be taken by the Radiant squad. And so, that's going to be the end of that engagement. So hopefully y'all enjoyed that commentary, and stay tuned for more very, very soon, and thank you all for watching.